Welcome back to Fallout 4. So I need to turn in a quest to Preston Garvey, and then I'm going to head to the Starlight Drive-In to go clear out a monster lair or something like that that's there. But before that, I realized I have a skill point to spend, and I know what I want to spend it on. So before I was kind of putting points into intelligence to work my way down this list to be able to get Scrapper and Science. I want Scrapper because it allows me to salvage some uncommon components, which would be really useful. Screws, aluminum, and copper, especially. And Science because that will allow me to use more mods on my energy weapon. So I want those. So I want to put more points into intelligence. However, I just realized, I was looking down the list of abilities that are not unlocked in the other lines, like perception, for example, and I realized if I put one more point in perception, I unlock Sniper, which is my character class, right? That is, my entire character build is supposed to be a sniper. A smooth-talking sniper. So it really just makes sense to put another point into perception to unlock Sniper. Now, unfortunately, the first level of Sniper is not all that good. You have improved control and can hold your breath longer when aiming with scopes. To be honest, I don't really care. That doesn't make much of a difference to me. However, the next level of it. Scope rifles have a chance of knocking down your target. That sounds really good. And the next level also. Scope rifles gain 25% accuracy to headshots in VATS. So I think I definitely want this. It just makes sense. Popping heads from a distance in VATS. So I'm going to go ahead and put another point into perception. Then once I'm level 12, I can put a point into sniper. Then once I'm level 13, I'll be high enough level to put another point into sniper. I can start knocking down my targets. Although I don't like the fact that it says you have a chance of knocking down your target and it doesn't actually tell you what that chance is. I mean, are we talking like 25%, 50%, 75%? Is it occasional or most of the time? I don't know. So I think I'll do that for a bit and then probably go back on track to putting more points into intelligence. But who knows, I might change my mind. You can tell my character build is super focused. I'm just spending points all over the place and I don't even know what I want exactly. I just know I want to be able to do science, I want to be able to do weapon mods, I want to focus on sniper rifles. Hopefully I'm not spreading my points out too thin. Alright, Preston.
What do you need, General?
I'm sorry, I wouldn't be very good company right now.
What now?
A pack of ghouls has holed up near a settlement. They could use our help. I'll mark it on your map. We can use all the support we can get, so see what you can do to help.
Okay, another settlement to help out. It's good, every settlement we help out is another settlement that I can use to get help from using my flare gun. Although, let's be honest, I'm probably never going to use my flare gun. And you know what? I think there's actually a skill that helps with settlements. It's under Charisma. Yeah, if I just get one more point in Charisma, I can actually get Local Leader. As the ruler everyone turns to, you're able to establish supply lines between your workshop settlements. Now, I don't know what that actually means. What is a supply line between workshop settlements? What does that really mean? I don't know. And if you get level 2 of it, you can build stores and workstations at workshop settlements. That sounds cool. I don't know how much I want to focus on my settlement, though. But I think it would be kind of cool to focus on it, so maybe I will. At some point. But not for now. Okay, where's that other settlement? Next thing I was going to do is the Starlight Drive-In, but let's see what the ghoul problem at Greentop Nursery is. Wait a minute, haven't I... Oh no, I haven't discovered it yet. No, okay. Have I been there? No. Okay, so I can get pretty close to it. Alright, let's go to the Starlight Drive-In, complete that quest, and then go help out the settlement. That sounds good. Mm-mm.
Thanks for helping us out with Trudy. You did good. Now, let's talk business.
Business? You mean trade, or do you have something for me?
To sell. Strictly medicinal.
Uh-huh. Yeah, no thanks.
I got a store to run here. You gonna buy?
Yes.
Sure. Let's take
all salvage.
I want to see if you have any energy weapon ammo. What the hell is energy weapon ammo actually called? Well, I know it's none of that, so nope. Oh, you know what? Oh. I'll try to remember. I want to go get the gun. If you remember the gun at the very beginning in Vault 111? The gun that I couldn't get to because I couldn't pick the lock? I want to go back there and get it. I thought you couldn't go back down into the vault, but as somebody told me, apparently you can. So I'm going to try to remember to actually do that. But let's focus on this. I came here for this. Let's do this. Hold on, dog meat. Target down. Alright. Drive-in's all clear. I think we're done here, dog meat. Oh my god. I really, really, really need ammo for this thing. Look at that. I've only got 29 shots for it. Hmm. Do some crafting. Blood bug steak. Deathclaw steak. This is not a very good weapon for this, but I don't want to use the ammo on my other gun. Oh my god, I keep missing. Alright, let's use bats. Whoa, I'm getting attacked. Didn't even see you there. Hey. Holy shit. That's it? Just a bunch of mole rats? I thought it'd be something serious. Let's do some more cooking while we're here. Radiation. Shit. That's the pool of water, right? Yeah. I think I have some anti-radiation stuff, like something that gives me radiation resistance. I'd be damned if I know what it is, though. I've got a million things. It's Rad X, right? Rad Resist 100, yeah. Alright, let's do that. Still getting radiation, but not as much. Oh my god, I'm getting a lot of radiation. There better be something good in here. Yeah, radioactive barrels. Shit, is there really nothing here? Well, crap. That was a waste. Let's get rid of this dang marker. if I could just click on you. If I could just... What? Maybe it already got rid of it? I don't know. Oh, fuck! Oh, I was about to say, somebody left the radio on? Well, if they set up a trap here, then I guess somebody lives here. Thought there might be a trap in there. Let's be on the lookout for more, too. That's probably copyrighted music. Why don't you be quiet? It's probably too late. My account's probably already banned. I'm gonna fill up so fast taking this junk. Especially the heavy stuff like fire extinguishers. It's like they're looking right at the staircase. Just watching for anybody coming up. Carrying too much. Look at that view. It's nice looking. All right, dog meat, come here. Gonna have to strap another 100 pounds to your back. I'm sorry. Where did you go? Don't make me go too far, please. I can barely move. There you are.
Hey.
Agatha's dress. I don't remember picking that up. I need to try that on. Looks like that might be better than what I've got on, so I'm gonna check that out in just a second. Red dress I also want to try on. And you can have all of my junk. Oh, it's all you can carry. Okay, yeah, let's check out the... apparel. So, right arm. Oh, wait a minute. What's my current right arm? Yes, the lucky right arm. The +2 luck, so no, we're definitely gonna keep that. But let's... I wish there was a way to easily cycle between, or like, preview what a piece of armor is gonna look like. Because I want to put the dress on, but it's gonna take off all my armor, which is gonna make it so annoying to put it back on. So annoying. Screw it. I'm gonna do it. Oh my god, that's lovely. Let's get in the sun. Oh, I've even got heels on. That's so cool looking. Now what about the red dress? Is it gonna look the same as the other red dress I had? No, that's different. Whoops. Pretty sparkly. It's really nice looking. Okay, now I need to try to put my armor back on. Oh my god, I think I can do it. I think it was like almost all this stuff. Lucky right arm, left arm. That I think that's it. Right arm, left leg. Oh wait, no, I need that. I need left arm as well, right? Yeah. No, that. Yeah. Okay, we're good. Yeah, we're good. That's right, I've still got this thing. Automatic. Okay, now we can move. We're mobile. Let's go install the radio thingamajig. Shit, that's a lot of radiation.
That's it.
Workshop. What am I supposed to do with it? Wait. I can build stuff here? Holy crap, I can actually build stuff here. I thought I was limited to Sanctuary. Alright, yeah, what am I supposed to make here? Build and activate recruitment radio beacon. Oh, here it is. Yeah, it's under power for some reason. I don't know why. And it does require power, so I'm gonna have to build a generator too, but that's fine. Attracts new settlers to your settlement when turned on. I guess I should probably put one of these at Sanctuary too. Alright. Where should I put it? Let's put it somewhere central and cool looking. What about right here? Boom. Okay, now we need power. Generator. Let's make a little generator. Let's connect it. And there we go. Settlement recruitment beacon found. Dr. Preston Garvey. Oh, whoops. Huh, you can actually turn it off if you want to. Cool. Okay, now before I forget, let's go back to Vault 111. Oh, I tried to fast travel while I was in the air. Whoops. What'd you find? I'm coming. I'm coming. Show it to me. Oh. Cool. Okay, so that's why I thought you could never go back inside of the vault. Because I pressed the button, and seemingly nothing happens, but apparently, from what people told me, if you go and stand on it after pressing the button, then it... Yeah, okay. That's weird. You press the button and then you just... nothing happens, and then you go stand on the thing, and then it actually takes you down. That's just, like, really poor feedback. You should... something should happen when you press the button, some indication that it's actually going to take you down when you stand on it. Dog meat's already down at the bottom? What? Teleporting dog. Open faster! This is a speed run, I've got no time to lose. Oh my god, this is gonna be a red split. I don't actually remember where that thing was.
Oh god. Oh god.
Yeah, where was that? This place thankfully isn't too big. Definitely was not in here. Was in some high security place. Don't get chalked by the thingy. Let's go around. This is the overseer's office. Oh, there it is. Yes.
Don't think I can pick this.
I still can't pick it. But somebody told me something, I don't know if it's true. They said if you ask Dogmeat to find an item, it's actually possible for them to get the Cryolator. I don't understand how that'd be possible, because it's freaking locked behind a case, and I don't think Dogmeat can pick locks. I mean, as talented as dogs are, I don't think they're that talented. But I'm gonna try it. And if it happens, then maybe it's a bug?
Hey.
I don't know. Let's see.
How you doing, buddy?
Okay, so fetch...
Hey, boy. Think you can find something for me?
Fetch an item, I guess?
See if there's any good stuff nearby, boy.
Are you seriously gonna... What? Oh my god, Dogmeat, I love you! That doesn't make any sense, but I don't care. That's gotta be a bug, right? You beautiful pooch. Mwah, mwah, mwah. I wanna give you, like, a banquet of food to eat, but I don't think I can do that. I don't think there's any way to do that. I wanna pamper you. You deserve it.
Bingo.
Oh, I have no idea if this is gonna be any good, but man, is it beautiful. I mean, it's behind a master lock, which means at my level, I'm not even capable of putting a point to actually get it up to the point of being able to take out master locks. Let's see. Next level. Yeah, you're not even supposed to be able to pick master locks until you're level 18, and I'm level 11. Holy crap. Let's take a look at this weapon. Damage 22, let's put on my good weapon, Righteous Authority. It does way less damage. Uses cryo? Does that mean I have no ammo for it? Yeah, that uses cell, this uses cryo, yeah, so I don't have any ammunition for this thing. But I think I saw some ammunition for it at the diner. The fire rate is really good. Range... Eh. Accuracy, it's okay. Heavy, it's really heavy. The stats don't look amazing, but let's see how this thing actually performs. Can only imagine how freezing your hands would be touching that. Need to wear gloves. Oh, look at that scope, it's so cool. The iron sights are just like two little... almost like needles or something. Can you fast travel when you're underground? Yeah, you can. Oh, no, I can't. Shit. Alright, what's the way out of here? I want to immediately go get ammo for that thing and try it out. Here we go. Dogmeat! You're trapped down here forever. No, you'll just teleport. You're fine. Oh, Look at the night sky. Look at those stars. There's no light pollution to make it so you can't see the stars anymore. Wow, that is really weird. The moon is a 2D sprite that orients itself depending on where you're looking. If you notice, it spins when I move my view. That is really strange. Anyway, Preston. I think it's faster to run than to fast travel. Just right here. Preston might be sleeping. Yeah, he's sleeping. Wake up!
I cleared out that spot you sent me to and set up a radio beacon there.
That's great news. Once folks have some place to call their own, they'll be willing to help defend it. As usual, I have something else for you to look into. I've gotten word about a settlement that's being threatened by raiders.
Raiders?
I'll
no
mark
way!
It on your map. We'll find out what they need. We can use more settlements supporting our cause.
It's always raiders. I don't know. It feels good, though, to help out these settlements. Feels kind of like I'm doing something. Even if it is almost always raiders. Or mole rats. And, yeah, this place obviously has the ability to support hundreds of people, I suppose. But there's only, what, like 5 people here? People 5. Yeah, just 5. So maybe I should set up a radio beacon here. Oh, wait, but I don't think I have the stuff to do it. I think I was running out of some other things. Right? There we go. Controls are broken for a second. Yeah, I need 4 more copper to do it. Yep, okay, so I can't do it yet. I am gonna process a bunch of junk here, and I'll be right back.
Guess you've got your reasons, but that just looks like junk to me.
I don't need your opinion, Preston. Go back to sleep. Thank you. Okay, I sorted all my stuff, dumped a bunch of things, stored junk, all that sort of stuff, and I'm just about to sell a bunch of stuff to the shopkeeper here at the diner and buy some cryo cells. Done. So how's my weight looking? 156 out of 230? Not bad. Still surprisingly heavy, though. I'm not quite sure why. I guess the cryolator doesn't help, because it does weigh 13 pounds. Ooh, I forgot to sell the glow-sided heavy hunting rifle. That also weighs 12. Well, that's fine. I'll just stick that on dog meat at some point anyway. In the meantime, do you know what we need to test? This thing! And I've got cryo cells. Wow, I just bought like 3 cryo cells and I have a crap ton of ammo. Oh, it's like a flamethrower! Hmm. This could do a lot of damage really fast up close. The damage per hit is relatively low, but I'm assuming that like one little puff, like that, will do that amount of damage. And if you hold it down, that's a lot of damage really quick. Okay. So I'm gonna try to test that out against an enemy if it's particularly tough or if I'm really close to it. Okay, where to now? It is time to talk to the settlers at Greentop Nursery. Let's go to the closest place next to it, the cemetery. This is one of those beautiful moments in the game. And apparently there's an enemy in there. Let's try the cryolator out. Where are they, dog meat? The inside?
You're mine,
hey.
What the?
Oh my god! Wow. I mean, I'm pretty sure Raider Scum are really weak in general, but still, that was fast. It's raining. Now it's all miserable. Ragsdag. Don't worry, I'm not gonna bother you. Go about your thing. So Malden Center, for some reason, is marked on my map, even though I've never actually been there. So I'm guessing, like, I was reading something and it marked it on my map, so there must be something interesting there. That's my guess. Otherwise, why would it be there? Let's check it out. Whoa, I see an enemy marked on my map over here. Or, I did. It's gone now. What the hell was that? Red Scorpion. Whoa, where? Oh, hey! Oh, shit! Oh, look at that! Yeah! Bash it! Let's get it, dog meat! Oh my god, that's so cool! Let's wake it up! This weapon's amazing! I'm gonna blow through the ammo super fast, but... Wow. I've got shit tons of radiation, I need to get rid of that. Eat some meat. Just did some baking, Oh, mutant hound chops actually takes away radiation and gives you HP, that would have been perfect. Yeah, so I'm gonna save this energy weapon right now for really good enemies, really tough ones, since I'm so limited on ammunition. I'll probably use my pistol for kind of weak stuff up close.
What? Who's there?
Whoa. Back off. Legendary Super Mutant Skirmisher. This is a boss battle. Or a mini boss battle or whatever. Okay. Well, this is gonna need the good guns, then. Let's try to take out all the adds and then go for the legendary skirmisher. How much health? Oh, wait a minute, you're gonna die in a couple hits, apparently. You've got low health, even though you're level 16. Huh. Well, in that case... I'm just gonna shoot your right arm twice. Or, well, actually, no, let's just shoot your torso twice, and then you're dead. Wait, what? Hold on a second. Did Vats just lie to me? Didn't say they would die in two hits, and yet, in reality, they were only hurt like 20% of their health? What just happened? Shit. Get the bomb! That still hurt. I thought it was far enough away. Shit. Okay, hold on. Freeze! Hello, Super Mutant. Legendary Super Mutant. This gun is amazing. Mighty double barrel shotgun. 25% more damage. Night vision, powerful pipe sniper rifle. Oh, that might be better than what I've got. Let's eat a hearty meal after that fight. That was so easy. I was taking so much damage, but god, the cryolator just killed them in a couple seconds flat and stopped them from firing because they were frozen. I really do wish it was easier to find the stuff you just baked. Yeah, it's fine. Almost max. Okay, let's take a look at that sniper. Alright, so this is what I'm currently using. By comparison, this does less damage, does a lot less damage. However, it uses a type of ammunition that I have a bajillion of. The fire rate is really high. Range is a little bit less, accuracy is a little bit less, weight is better, value is better. Okay. So it's really good, but it's kind of a different type of sniper than my current one. The fire rate is more of like a pretty much shoot as fast as you want to click kind of sniper rifle instead of my current one, which is extremely slow. Let's give it a shot. There's the night vision, which is painful during the day. Ugh. I wish you could turn off the night vision. I do like the fast firing, though. But this is definitely not the kind of sniper you want to use for doing headshots from a distance. This is more of like a medium-range rifle. Not a long range, it's a medium range rifle. This one's definitely better for super far range. I need to, like, sort my guns at some point. Right. We need to check out this hospital. Medford Memorial Hospital. Still don't remember why this was marked on my map exactly. It's gotta be more inside, right? Yep, caution. Somebody heard me, or saw me.
Someone there.
Is invisible. Come on.
I hear something.
Can I get the hand? Yes, there we go. Gotcha. Little bit hard to stay stealthy after that.
I'm hearing stuff.
You're hearing stuff. Yeah, you're hearing a massive explosion.
Found you.
What? Where?
Come on! Let's
oh!
Run!
Hey. Oh, the kickback on this thing is crazy. It's shit.
12 is ours!
No! Stupid dog!
Hellhound! Ooh. That's not gonna kill it. Shit, I'm really low. No, I don't want to loot the body. Reload. There's a lot of them out there. Try to cripple the arm. That doesn't look like it did shit. Oh, dog meat's getting stuck on stuff. Poor dog meat. Pathfinding is a dog's worst friend. Don't you shoot dog meat! You fuck!
Bleed and die!
I'm gonna shove some food down my throat. Try sorting by value again, that helps a little bit. Little bit. Not that much. I'll just take some purified water, that's fine. Oh shit, hey. Oh fuck! Holy shit! The world's exploding! And dog meat's on fire. Now I need more food. Come on, you come to me.
Gonna eat your dog! When you go,
really? You're gonna eat my dog? No, you ain't.
Here! Run! Run!
I'm gonna use your body as ice cubes. Stop burning dog meat, you asshole. Oh crap, I'm crippled. I am very, very crippled. My arms. Is there a specific way to heal my arms? Or do I just heal? Maybe I just heal and I'm fine. Does that uncripple my arms? Yeah, that uncrippled my arms. Great.
Go ahead and hide, little bleeder.
There's still so many of them, I can't even explore this place without taking them out. Okay, they're on this level.
Come out wherever you are.
What if I try the shotgun I got? Hmm? The super, super good one.
Slippery humans. Who's there? It was nothing.
Yeah, so I'm gonna clear first.
What's that?
Clear first, explore later. That did a lot of damage. Nice. This thing's fairly accurate, too. Hold on. Two enemies close together. Let's start using... Molotov cocktails. I want to throw Molotov cocktails at me. I'll throw some Molotov cocktails at you, motherfucker. I just burned my own dog and just crippled myself. I'm sorry, dog meat. You'll be okay. Legendary enemy has mutated. What? What does that mean? Mutated during the fight? What? Looks like it's enraged or something. It's alright, we're about to kill it. And killing blow to the crotch. Unfortunately, the crotch is not in bats, but it's okay. You can select it yourself. Yeah, this shotgun's really nice for peeking around corners. If you're fighting enemies that aren't melee, ones that will stay back a little bit, it's really nice. Peek out, fire a couple shots, go back into cover. It's good. It's awfully good. I really don't know what weapons I want to use, to be honest. I've got like 6 weapons I kind of want to use, sort of. I guess at this point I can pretty much just ditch the auto pistol. I think that's just pretty useless. Yeah, let's explore. Collect a lot of junk. Emphasis on a lot of junk, because, oh my god, I'm already carrying too much. Dog meat.
Heads up. Wait there.
Take all my junk, please. Even with all my junk gone, I'm still so overweight. Yeah, so I don't need the night vision powerful pipe sniper rifle, right? Oh, no, that is the one I'm using. I do want that. It's that I don't need. Definitely don't need a bunch of boards. That's good. Long johns. I still have a lot of weight, even with all my junk and extra weapons gone. I'm not entirely sure where that's all coming from, to be honest. I guess you can have all my mods. That's not that much weight. Is it ammo? I don't think ammo has any weight. No, it doesn't. Ammo has no weight. So where is it coming from? Is it coming from aid? It might be aid. Like canned dog food, each one of those weighs 1/2 pound. Cram weighs 1/2 pound. Yeah, I should clear that out at some point. But the time for that is not now. I don't feel like it. Chemistry station. Craft some drugs, sure. Get some XP, we're pretty close to leveling up. Looks like that's it. I definitely want all this stuff too, it really is useful crafting ingredients. I know there's all sorts of optics and hopefully copper too in these things. Recoil compensated powerful pipe sniper. Okay, it's worth taking a look at. And the legendary body fell down there, so I need to make sure to loot that because it's probably got really good stuff on it. Is that any good? Nah, that thing's crappy. Alright, what is on your body? Martyr's metal left arm. Another lucky arm, maybe? Temporary slows down time during combat when you are at 20% or less health. Huh. gives you more time to heal and react. That sounds good. Let's see how the stats compare. Yeah, let's take a look. So I need to take a look at the sniper rifle and the stats of that piece of armor. You. Let's see how you compare to... Let's put on my other sniper. Which one? The fast-firing one? Or the slow? Compare it against the slow. Oh no, it's actually a fast-firing one, so let's compare it against the fast-firing one. Which is... that one. Oh, fire rate's the same, range is better, accuracy is better, weight is better. Unless I'm crazy, it's better in every way, except for some reason it's worth less money. Except it doesn't have the night vision scope. But it's got better range and accuracy and everything. It's not that much better, though. I like the scope on this thing a lot more. Holy shit. Holy shit. This place is gonna take a long time to search. A long time. There's like a dozen or two dozen rooms and I'm on the second floor. Oh god, there's three floors. And this episode is already going long. I just looked over and... yeah, it's looking long. Okay. If I keep playing this game until I feel like I've done everything, this episode's gonna be like 50 hours long, so... for the sake of my sanity, I'm gonna have to call it here. So I hope you've enjoyed so far, and when I return, I'm going to sweep this place for loot.